Let us continue with composition formal letter. Now in today's video, we are going to see how to write a formal letter and what is a formal letter. Before vacations, we had learned how to write an informal letter, okay? So today we are going to see how to write a formal letter. So let us begin. Now first we will understand what are letters. Letters are way of expressing our feelings and thoughts to our dear and loved ones. Yes. So why we write letters? We write letters to express our feelings or to express our emotions to someone who is very close to us. It can be family. It can be members of the family. It can be, you know, friends. It can be anyone who likes you like so much and you want to share with that person everything. So letters are the way to express your feelings and emotions. And earlier in olden days, when technology like, you know, mobile phones, internet facilities were not available, people used to communicate with each other through letters. So letters played a very important role in olden days. Okay, now some letters are also written to ask permission or to sort a problem. Now letters are two types, okay? There are two types of letters. One which we saw was informal letter, and today which we are going to see is formal letter. So formal letters are letters written for, you know, to ask permission or to sort some problem. So these are they are called as formal letters. Now types of letters, as I told you, how many types of letters? Two types of letters. First one is formal letters, second one is informal letters. We have already learned informal letters. We are going to learn today about formal letters. Now let me tell you in detail what is formal letter. Formal letters are letters written for official purposes to authorities, seniors, and they are known as formal letter. Okay, so someone who is holding a higher position, okay, take an example of school. So in the school, the highest position is held by the principal. So if you want to ask permission regarding some, you know, something you want to ask, and that teacher cannot solve that problem and that is not in teacher's hand, so you are going to write the letter to the principal. Suppose you want a leave of 1 month, urgent, for some urgent work you have to go somewhere and you have to do that work, so you need a leave of 1 month. So for that you have to ask permission from the principal of the school whether she grants you the permission of 1 month leave. And if she says yes, or if he or she, whoever it is, if they say yes, then you can take the leave. So these are the official, and they are, you know, very to the point letters. In your, nothing in detail is written, like how are you, then I did this. You will not share your emotions and feelings. You'll just write what you want to ask and for what you have written the letter, and then you're going to end the letter, nothing else, okay? Because they are, you know, they are holding a higher position. They don't have time to read all your how are you, what are you doing, how was your day. These all, they don't have so much of time. They will just, you know, read what the problem is and they will try to sort out whatever the problem is. So these are called as formal letters. Now formal letters are not written to personal contacts, friends or family. As I told you, formal letters are not the letters which we write to our family members or which we write to our relatives or friends. They are, you know, to the point, and they are written to authorities who hold higher position. Such letters require specific and formal words. Formal words means you have to be to the point. You don't have to write like, you know, you're not going to use anywhere how are you, what are you doing, how is everything going on. These all things you're not going to write. You're just going to mention your name. You're just going to mention the problem, whatever it is, or the permission, whatever you want to ask, and then you're going to end the letter. So it is to the point. It is short and to the point, and it only mentions the specific reason for what you have written the letter. Nothing else in that. and they are brief and to the point. Yes, to the point. You're not going to add anything extra. You're not going to add anything personal about your feelings, about your emotions. Nothing, nothing, nothing. Only for what the reason the letter is written that you're going to mention in the letter. Now, it follows a particular format. See, informal letter also followed a particular format. But formal letter has certain, you know, addition in it which you have to follow, okay? And if you, without that format, you cannot write a formal letter. So, let us see. Now, first one, see, this is the format of a formal letter, okay? First one is sender's address with PIN code. Sender's means the one who is writing the letter is known as sender, and the one who is reading the letter, the one with to whom you have written the letter, they are known as receiver. So sender's address means your address along with the PIN code of your area. So PIN code is important. That is why I have mentioned there with PIN code. Okay. Second one is date. Okay. On which date you have written the letter, that date will be mentioned. Third one is receiver's address. Yes, receivers means the to whom you have written the letter, even that person's address will come. Okay. Then comes the subject. See, this is something new in formal letter. In informal letter, we did not have a subject. In formal letter, we are going to write a subject. Subject means you are going to write the, you know, mention the reason of writing the letter in short. Whatever you want. Suppose I told you, you want permission of 1 month leave. So you are going to write, you know, permission of 1 month leave, and you're going to, that is your subject. So from your subject, the receiver should understand what is the letter about. So your subject, you know, tells everything about the letter. So that is subject. Okay. Then comes the salutation part, right? You are going to whom you are, suppose you are writing to the principal. So you are going to write to the principal. Okay. Like that. Then comes sixth one is body of the letter. So body of the letter means you are going to start, you know, writing for what you have written the letter. That is called the body of the letter. And then comes the conclusion part. See, here no three paragraphs, here only two paragraphs. First is body of the letter, and then comes the conclusion part. Okay. Then is the complimentary closure. Means you're going to thanking you. In formal letter, you're going to use this word in all the formal letters, like thanking you, because you're asking something and you know that they are going to, you know, 99% whatever it is, they are going to grant it. So you're going to get that whatever you have asked. So you are going to thanking you in every formal letter. And then your sender's signature means your signature means I'll show you how to write that. That is, that will come at the end. Is that clear? So this is the format which you are going to follow while writing a formal letter. And all these 9 points, go through, make a note of it if you want to in your notebook. As I'm explaining, you just make a note of it. And if you keep this format in mind, it will be very easy for you to write a formal letter. So let us begin. See, this is an example which I have given a formal letter here. Write a letter to the principal of your school for granting permission for leave of 1 week. So now you're not going to attend the school for 1 week. 1 week means 7 days. Okay. So 7 days you're not going to attend school, and you're going to write this letter for asking permission from the principal. Okay. Now here comes the format. We are going to follow the format and we are going to write the letter. So pay attention. See, the black one, the first three lines are the address, that is your address should be written short. And see, it is not necessary to write your real address. Keep your address simple and sweet so that you don't make spelling mistakes, along with the PIN code. Okay, along with the PIN code. So see what I have written: 202, Happy Valley, Sun Lane, Thane West, 400604. So that is the PIN code. So I have written my address in just three lines, one below the other, at the, you know, left hand side. Everything will be on the left hand side. Okay. Now without leaving lines, you're going to write this. And then follows the date. Okay. Now date also has a particular format. See how I have written. Second to and ending up. So that is 2nd February. I'll write the name of the month in full form. Okay. Not short. I have not written FEB. No, that is wrong. any month, whichever you write, you are going to write the full name of the month, okay? Then give a comma and then write the year in full. 2020, don't only write 20. See, I have written 2020, I have written in full. So that makes your date complete. So what did you get the format of writing the date also? First comes the date, whatever it is, 12th, 1st, 2nd, 3rd, like that you are going to write the date, okay? Then the name of the month in full. Then you will give a comma and then you are going to write the year also in full, like 2020. Now comes your receiver's address, okay? Now you can, without leaving line, you can write 2, comma, and just below the comma, see the purple part, the principal. Now here many of you go wrong while writing the principal spelling. You write it as P-L-E, P-R-I-N-C-I-P-A-L. That is the correct spelling of principal. You write principal, that is wrong, okay? So get, if you want, you write the principal spelling 5 times so that you don't make a mistake, okay? Then to the principal, now your school's name, Shrima Balniketan High School, okay? And where it is in Thane. So I have written Thane. Here you don't need to write pin code. Only when you are writing your address, that is the sender's address, their pin code will come. In the receiver's address, pin code is not necessary, okay? So here also, now your sender's address is over, date is over, receiver's address is over, okay? Now you're going to write the subject. You're going to write the subject in between. See, I have written in between. And very, very important, you're going to underline the subject. Whatever it is, you're going to underline the subject. See, I have written the subject in short. Permission for leave of 1 week. That itself is in the question. So your subject itself is in the question. So from there only you have to just copy it down and you have to underline it. And where you will write it, you will write in between. Okay, you will write in between. See how the format looks. And this all carries marks. So it is very, very easy, children. Okay, you just have to follow the format. You have to write neatly without making any mistakes and cutting. And then you will get marks. Okay, so follow this format. Now after the subject follows the salutation part, that you are going to whom you have written to the principal. Suppose the principal of your school is a lady, so you are going to write madam. Suppose it is a man, you are going to write sir. So whatever it is, okay? So we have a lady, that is a principal, so you are going to refer it as madam, okay? So respected madam, comma, and you are going to start writing the letter. I, Naina Jain, from 4th B, has written this letter to grant permission of leave for 1 week, okay? So, I will mention, you are going to mention your name because the principal does not know who are you. There are so many children in the school. So, it is very, very important that you mention your name. You mention from which standard and from which division you are. Okay, so the principal is very, very clear that yes, this child from this division and standard wants a leave. Okay, you're going to mention your name and your standard and division. Then you're going to mention the reason of writing the letter for asking permission. And then you're going to write why you want leave for 1 day. That also reason is very, very important. As I have to attend marriage ceremony of my brother, which is at Delhi. Okay, so the marriage ceremony is not in Thane, it is not in Bombay, it is out of town, so it is at Delhi. Okay, so I will need 1 week to attend my brother's ceremony. See, 1 day for traveling, 1 day for coming, so 2 days are gone in traveling only, and the remaining 5 days in marriage ceremony of my brother. So that is why I need 7 days leave. So you have to, whenever you're writing a formal letter, you have to be true also, okay? You have to mention the specific and the correct and the accurate reason of why you need a leave here, okay? Whatever it is, okay? If you're going to village, if you're going somewhere, mention why are you going to village. That also reason is important so that the principal understands clearly, yes, it is a genuine reason and I should grant leave to that particular student. So you should be genuine too while writing the letter, okay? So now I have mentioned my reason. Now I will mention the date, from which day to which day I want leave and when I will be back to school. That also you have to mention. So I will be on leave from 10th February to 16th February. Now children, here I want to tell you specifically. See, if you see, you have written the letter, if you go back and see below the address, you have written the letter on 2nd February, okay? And your marriage, your brother's marriage is on 10th February. Why I have written the letter so early, that is 1 week before on 2nd February? Yes, children, see, suppose you are going to go on 10th February, you are not going to write the letter on 9th February and give it to the principal, no. Because these things are already planned and you already know, and it's not going to get cancelled unless and until it is something, you know, bad, urgency or emergency, whatever. So you are going to take a, you know, very prior permission, like 1 week before permission, so that the principal also gets time to think whether if he or she thinks it is a valid reason, then they will grant permission. But if you ask one day, just 1 day before, and you're going to write a letter, it is wrong. So 1 week before you have to write the letter, and so that the dates, see, look at the dates. I have written the letter on 2nd Feb and I am going to leave on 10th February. So before 1 week, I have just asked permission. 1 day before asking permission is not a good thing, because these things are already planned, you know. So it is better you write 1 week before. Is that clear? So have you got the dates, how to write? See, if I have to go on leave on 10th, I will not write the letter on 9th. Is that clear? I will write it 1 or 5 or 6 days before only I will ask permission. Is that clear? Now see, very very important, why to mention the dates? Because it is a record of your, you know, in the attendance register also, like, this child has not attended school from 10 to 16 February. So in the attendance record also, it does not make a mistake, or, you know, it is very very clear for the class teacher too. So that is why you have to mention the dates, on which day you are going to go and from which date you are not going to be there, and when are you going to come back to school. And I will join school from 17 February. So 16 February I will be back from Delhi, and the next day, that is 17 February, I will join the school. So you are very very clear. So what have you written in the letter? You have mentioned the reason, for how many days you want leave, and for what reason you are taking the leave, and you have mentioned the dates, for how many days you are going to be, the date you have mentioned, and what date you are going to join the school back, that also you have mentioned. So very, see, I was very, you are very clear here, you are to the point, you have written the letter to the point, nothing, you know, out of the box you have written in. Okay, so now next part, see, that comes your conclusion part, the blue part. The body part of the letter is over. Okay, the main thing I have already mentioned, and it is very very clear. I assure you that I will recover the loss of studies. Yes, if I am remaining absent, it is my duty to see that I complete the work given in the school, the homework, the class work, ask some friends, get it done from them. See, it is our duty. If you are remaining absent, it is your duty to complete your work. Nobody is going to come on their own and tell you, "Arey, this is work. This you have missed out, you write this." No, it is your duty to ask to your friends whatever you have missed, and you assure, that means you give a promise that you are going to, you know, write everything whatever you have missed out. You are going to take notes of whatever you have missed out, and you are going to cover that up. So this shows that you are a sincere and a dedicated child, okay, and you are bothered about your studies which you have missed out. And there are some children also that they are not bothered also. They don't ask also, "Miss, what was given?" They don't ask their friends also. And then at the time of exam, they remember, "Hey, this important notes I had not written, but I was absent during that day." And then they ask searching, and then they find at the last moment. And that is not valid. And at the last moment or at the last minute, whatever you study, you know, 50% also does not go in your mind. Because you are in a hurry, you just want to learn, you mug up whatever it is, all mixed up in your brain, and you yourself are confused at the last moment. What you have learned, you can't remember also. So very very important, children, whenever you are absent, whether it is 1 day absent or 2 days absent or many days absent, it is your duty the next day when you come to school to ask whatever, what was given in the class, what teacher had taught, and then you can take notes from your friends and you can try to, you have to complete them, not on Monday, but try to complete it slowly, slowly, but make it a point to complete it. and that is called sincerity. Okay, now so kindly do the needful. So you are asking permission because principal is a higher authority. Okay, the principal manages the school, everything is under her control. So you have to ask gently and, you know, humble request you have to make, that so kindly do the needful. Needful means kindly grant me leave for 1 week. Okay, now this is your conclusion part is over. Now comes your, you know, this, what do you call, thanking. You are going to thanking you. Okay, in advance only you are going to thanking you. Okay, then yours faithfully. See, this is your signature part. Signature part means you are going to write yours faithfully or yours sincerely also. You can use, here I have written yours faithfully, comma, XYZ. Why XYZ? Because in the first paragraph you had already mentioned your name. Okay, so you need not mention your name again. See, this is the signature part, that is your XYZ. Okay, so you're not going to mention your name again. The principal already knows who are you. So you're just going to write XYZ or ABC, whatever, but in capital letters. See that XYZ, all the three letters are in capital. So same way you're going to write, and everything is on the left hand side, nothing is on the right hand side. Means whatever it is, the salutation part, the thanking part, okay, everything comes on the left hand side. Am I very clear? And have you understood now how to write a formal letter and what is a formal letter? Is that clear? So thank you children for listening to me carefully. Goodbye. Take care.